Stakes racing continues. This time around, we go to the Saratoga of the South. It's Oaklawn Park, and it's time for the Hot Spring Stakes for three-year-olds. Starting to think a little bit about Preakness now, and maybe some of the horses that can't get into the starting gate for the Kentucky Derby. They will be on the undercard races, like the Chick Lang, the Woody Stevens, and the Pat Day Mile. Let's take a look at the Hot Spring Stakes. It is going to go on Saturday at Oaklawn Park. They're going to go the 1 mile distance. It did draw a solid field of horses. We've got some horses from some of the Kentucky Derby points races dropping in class here for the Hot Spring Stakes. A field of 9 entered. Let's start off at the rail. We've got Otto the Conqueror. Of course, he conquered the Churchill Downs stretch, won that race by 4 lengths, won the Springboard Mile. Pressed the pace in the Southwest, ended up finishing 6th place that day. Otto the Conqueror goes back to his best distance at 1 mile. Carboni, another 2-time winner. He broke his maiden at Churchill Downs in a fast maiden race. Meanwhile, he came back at Oaklawn Park in a fast allowance race. Faded in the Southwest, and the Rebel drops in class here for the Hot Springs, but he's got to face some other speed in this race. Mena is another horse who was a nice claim for $30,000, finished 2nd to Northern Flame in an allowance race, and then faded in the Rebel Stakes, drops in class. Mr. Phillip is a horse who I think will like the 1 mile distance. He's got some speed. The sire is the Mighty Matoli, and he gets Kristen Torres to ride. Won a maiden race last time out with a 90 Brisnet speed figure. Footprint goes for trainer Ken McPeak, 3rd to Seize the Gray the last time out. Ran evenly late. This could be a prep for the Lexington Stakes for Footprint. Nash will be one of the favorites, goes for trainer Brad Cox. Of course, they had Derby hopes. He won by 10 at Churchill Downs in a mile and a 16th race. Ran 3rd in the Gunrunner, 2nd in the LeCompte, and ran 2nd last time out to Tuscan Sky. Nash trying to get backing on the winning end. Florent Giroux rides for Godolphin Blue. Meanwhile, the Count, Count Dracula. He broke his maiden at the Fairgrounds, won that race by 2, finished 2nd the last time out in a stakes race at Louis Fairgrounds, Black Gold Stakes. Frost Free adds some more speed, went wire to wire last time, 110 flat. He's by Frosted, and he adds speed to the race. On the outside, you've got Magic Grant. He was 2nd to Otto the Conqueror, actually 3rd to Otto the Conqueror in the Springboard Mile behind Otto the Conqueror and Glengarry. So Magic Grant needs to recapture that form. He's been 10th place in his last 2 finishes. Otto the Conqueror, Carboni, Nash, and Footprint. Those are the headliners here in the Hot Spring Stakes. Again, some of these horses might drop back to 6. Some might go 7 furlongs. Right now, they're going to try the 1 mile distance for 3-year-olds. Carboni, Nash, Otto the Conqueror, Count Dracula, Footprint. I think those are going to be the favorites on the betting board, but I think it's going to be kind of a wide open betting race between the top 3 contenders, Carboni, Nash, and Otto the Conqueror. Let's take a look at the replays, find out how they got here, some of the trip notes. We're going to go first with Carboni. Now, I think he's a need-to-lead type. Both his wins have been on the front end. Here he is at Oaklawn Park, going a route of ground, 2 turns, wins that race, draws off down the stretch, but he got pressured the last 2 times on the lead. Carboni needs an easy lead. Now, Otto the Conqueror, I think he can take a little bit of heat. He showed that in the Springboard Mile. Here he is with an extended stretch duel with Glengarry, going the length of the stretch from the turn all the way to the wire. Otto the Conqueror, I think, likes a fast track, and he could be sent, but he also can rate just a little bit in this spot. Another horse to consider is Nash. Here we're going to take a look at his race. You know, I thought this race was a good race in the Gunrunner. He was bet down to the big favorite. He makes a move here going into the turn. Then we pick him up in the stretch. He made another attempt at Track Phantom. Ended up running 3rd in this race. Nash has got some class. 1 mile distance should be good. And Nash goes for trainer Brad Cox. Another one to look at is Count Dracula. He picked up a win on the drop in a maiden special weight at Fairgrounds. Nice speed figure, Brisnet of 86, and he was 2nd in the Black Gold Stakes. Nice little pedigree. It'd be nice to see Count Dracula. He's also nominated for the Illinois Derby, so maybe this is a prep for that. Could see him in the Lexington, but first he's going to run here in the Hot Spring Stakes. 6 furlong pace. I've got a lot of speed in this race. You've got horses like Frost Free could go to the lead, but I put Otto the Conqueror on the lead with Carboni. I think whichever one of those two gets the lead, they're going to try to go on with it. The Presser, I think, getting a good trip this time around, should be Nash from that second flight. Then you've got Count Dracula from the mid-pack and Magic Grant. Magic Grant got a nice fast pace in the springboard mile, should get a fast pace here. Maybe he can close a little bit. I'm favoring the Pressers. Nash and Frost Free should get a good trip, but Otto the Conqueror and Carboni, we'll see which one of those two, trained by Steve Asmussen, heads for the initial lead. Now, the big questions when you're handicapping the Hot Springs, trainer intent. Carboni, can he rate a little bit, or is he going to be sent? That means Otto the Conqueror, how does he deal with the other speed? Carboni, Frost Free, and then can he hold off the closers like Magic Grant? Meanwhile, you've got Nash. He's going to be bet down because of those class running lines, but the 1 mile distance, dropping in class, sometimes three-year-olds start to go off form. We'll see if Nash can hold his form. Maybe this is a nice prep for either the Lexington Stakes, or this is a solid prep for the Preakness Stakes for Nash, who I think has a little bit of quality to him. That is some of the big questions. And my top selection in the Hot Spring Stakes is going to be Otto the Conqueror. I was impressed with his maiden win at Churchill Downs. I liked his stakes attempt at Springboard Mile. I thought he put in a good run there against Glengarry. Exactas, I'm going to play over Nash and Count Dracula. Carboni seems to be going off form with me. You definitely can make the case for Magic Grant in this race. He's going to get more speed. The last time he got speed pace, he was able to close in the Springboard Mile. And then Nash, he's going to be used on a lot of tickets on that class drop. So lots of ways you can go. I'm going to go with Otto the Conqueror. The road to the 150th Kentucky Derby continues. We've got previews up of the Jeff Ruby Stakes, the Bourbonette Stakes, Fairgrounds Oaks, and the Louisiana Derby. Don't forget next week, Florida Derby, Gulfstream Oaks, and the UAE Derby. Jeff Ruby Stakes preview is up. Make sure to watch that. A full field entered, some also eligibles, and a field of 12 for the Louisiana Derby. You've got Catching Freedom, Track Phantom, Tuscan Gold, Common Defense for Ken McPeak, and the Triple Crown Prospectus. I write up every Monday, 2,000 words. We rank the top contenders. We look at the filly contenders and more. Sign up in the description below. And the Hot Spring Stakes 2024. Don't forget, I've got a tip sheet. It's going to be coming out this week for the Fairgrounds. And also, you get signed up for the Derby, the Preakness, and the Belmont. Sign up in the description below. Who do you like in the Hot Spring Stakes? You got Otto the Conqueror. You've got Carboni. Make sure to check on those other previews that are up for the Fairgrounds Oaks and the Louisiana Derby and the Jeff Ruby Stakes. We're getting closer, inside 45 days now, to the 2024 Kentucky Derby. In the next week, we're going to have 7 major preps. We'll find out the Oaks top contenders and the Derby top contenders on the trail. Dwayne Lucas always says people have opinions and horses have the facts.